We are learning that the mastermind behind the largest Ponzi scheme in world history, Bernie Madoff, has died in prison.
The notorious Bernie Madoff died of natural causes at age 82 in a North Carolina federal prison hospital. And many of his victims are saying good riddance. Burn in hell, says the New York Post. The Drudge Report seems to agree, tinting his image in hellish red. Maureen Ebel was once a wealthy socialite until she lost $5 million to the Madoff con. Her cushy life was upended overnight. She had to resort to earning a living as a housekeeper, dusting, cleaning, vacuuming, mopping.
I felt like, well, there's one less thief in the world.
We caught up with 72-year-old Maureen Ebel today.
If you had the chance, what would you say to Bernie Madoff today?
I would like to ask him, when all is said and done, his two children have passed away, he's ruined many families' lives. Was it really worth it, Bernie?
Madoff's own downfall was Shakespearean. One son died of cancer. His other son, unable to deal with the family shame, hanged himself with a dog leash. Madoff's wife, Ruth, is still alive. She spoke to 60 Minutes in 2011.
You feel the shame?
Of course I feel the shame. I barely walk down the street.
Bernie Madoff's wife, Ruth, now lives in this waterfront home in a private community an hour and a half northeast of New York City near swanky Greenwich, Connecticut. We tried making contact with Ruth Madoff today.
Is Ruth here? Ruth available?
No, she's not. Where is she?
Would she like to make a comment or just...
No.
Madoff!